This video demonstrates how to make a smooth wing part in FreeCAD using an airfoil section loaded from a file. There's also an article on my blog page that accompanies this video and goes into a few more details, so I'll link that in the description. This is the part I'm going to make. It's a wing with sweep, taper and twist. The section is an accurate airfoil shape with the coordinates loaded from a file by a short macro. You can see the twist in the wing by looking at the tip section relative to the root section, and also that the thickness to chord ratio is lower at the tip. The result is a smooth 3D shape that follows the shape of the loaded airfoil section. Okay, first I'll create a new clean project. I'm using FreeCAD 18.4 and the standard Ubuntu 2004 long-term support version, up to date as of the date of this video. The first thing I'll do is create a sketch of the wing planform I want. I don't use this directly to make the wing, so you could just do this on paper, but it's convenient for checking the geometry as we go along. Select the sketcher module and start a new sketch. We'll use the XY plane to define the planform. I'll create the planform from four straight lines. So select the line tool and then start to make the lines roughly in the shape you want. It's not important to make accurate lines as we'll constrain them later. This will be the wing root. You'll see that when you create a line that's roughly horizontal, FreeCAD automatically adds a horizontal constraint. This will be the leading edge. And this will be the wingtip. If FreeCAD doesn't add the horizontal constraint, you can add it by selecting the constraint from the toolbar and then selecting the line you want to make horizontal. And this line will be the trailing edge. Now we'll constrain them to be connected. Select the coincident constraint and then select two points to join. Join all the four corners of the wing in the same way. We'll also constrain the wing root leading edge to be at the origin. We don't have any fixed dimensions yet, so we'll constrain the wing root and tip lengths using the horizontal distance constraint. I'll set the wing root to 100 millimeters. And we'll have a taper ratio of 0.25, so I'll set the tip chord to 25 millimeters. Next, I'll set the wing leading edge sweep to 35 degrees using the angle constraint. I'll do this by setting the angle between the root chord and the leading edge. This is 90 minus the leading edge sweep, so to get a sweep of 35 degrees, I need to set this angle to 55 degrees. Now the only thing left to fully constrain the sketch is to set the semi-span. Use the vertical distance constraint to set the vertical distance on the trailing edge to 90 millimeters. The sketch turns green because it's now fully constrained. I want to add one more guideline, so select the line tool and add a vertical line at roughly 50% of the tip chord. I'm going to set this with a horizontal distance constraint to be 12.5 millimeters aft of the tip leading edge. and then just tidy up the sketch a little bit. Okay, I'll also constrain it to extend 5 millimeters beyond the root and tip chords, just so that it's fully constrained. I'll use this guideline later to check the positioning of the tip chord. Okay, the sketch is complete, so close the sketcher. We'll use this plan form and guideline as a check that everything is in the right place as we build the wing. We're going to make a wing with an accurate profile, so I'm going to use a macro to load a NACA 2412 section from a file. I downloaded this section from the UIUC Airfoil data site linked in the description. For the macro I'm using, you need to load the airfoils in Selig format. This file has a single header line, followed by X and Y coordinates of the section. The points start at the trailing edge, go along the upper surface to the leading edge, and then back along the lower surface to the trailing edge. In this case, the two trailing edge points are not the same, which leaves us with a small trailing edge thickness to join later. Check my article about some issues you might have if the two trailing edge points are the same. To load the section as a B-spline, I've written a short macro that you can access from the macro menu if you place the macro in the right folder. See my article for the details and to download the macro and the wing section file. Select the macro from the list and press Execute. Now navigate to where you've stored your section file, select it and open. The section is only 1 millimeter long, so you'll need to zoom in a bit to see it. I'll just hide the sketch for the moment. As this is currently an open section, we need to close the airfoil trailing edge before making it into a single wire. To do this, select the draft module and the two-point line tool. Carefully join the two trailing edge points. If you approach from downstream, it should snap to the end points. Now you should have a B-spline and a line in the Model tab. Select both of these and then open the Draft menu and select Upgrade. You'll see that this joins the two lines into a single wire. If you zoom to the trailing edge, you'll see that it's now a closed section. We'll clone and scale this wire to make both our root and tip chords. So select the wire and then clone. Now rename the new wire. We'll call it root section. In the properties, we'll change the X and Z scale to 100 to scale it to match the sketch that we made earlier. You might need to press the refresh button to get it to display correctly. Now zoom out, turn on the sketch, and you'll be able to see that it's as we expected. Next, we do a similar thing for the tip section. Clone the original wire. Rename the clone tip section. This time for the scale, we make the X scale 25 to match our plan form. For the Z scale, I'm going to make it 12.5 rather than 25, which will modify the thickness to chord ratio to 50% of the original. That will make it a 6% T over C. Move the section out to the tip by setting the Y position to minus 90. And refresh if needed. You can see that the sketch helps to remind you what to do next. I need to move the tip section aft to match my sketch. The sweep is 35 degrees and the semi-span is 90, so I need to change X position to 90 times 1035, which is 63.02. Now we can see the tip section is correctly located. The only thing left to do with the tip is to add the twist. I'm going to add 5 degrees of washout using the angle property. I set the axis property to the y-axis, 0, 1, 0, then set the angle to 5 degrees. Okay, that's the wrong direction. This is where the sketch comes in handy as a check. So change the angle to minus 5. Now I've got 5 degrees of washout, but it's not exactly what I want. The rotation is applied before the translation, so it's rotated about the leading edge. I want it to be rotated roughly around the guideline that I set earlier. I can fix this by modifying the Z position of the tip chord. Just by eye, I guess 1 millimeter. But that's the wrong way, minus 1 millimeter. Not quite. About 1.3 millimeters seems to be good. I've got the tip height correct, so I haven't inadvertently added dihedral to the wing. Now all that's left is to make a part from these sections. I'll just hide the sketch and the section wire. Now select the part module and the loft tool. Add the root section and the tip section to the selected profiles. You have the choice of making a solid or a surface. Let's try the surface first. Click Surface and OK. Wait for the calculations. And there we have our surface. You can see it's not solid as the ends are not closed. Let's undo that and go back and make a solid. This time select the Create Solid checkbox and OK. And now we have a solid. You can see the wing twist by looking at the tip. And if you zoom in, you can see the wing has a trailing edge thickness. Now if you turn the sketch back on, you can see that we have the correct plan form, but it is a complex 3D shape with twist. Okay, that's it. See the article on my blog for more details and to download the macro, the wing section, and the final finished part. I'll probably make some more FreeCAD videos, so feel free to leave any comments or requests below.